So what are the qualities of the leader? The beautiful quality of the leader is the self-confidence. The leader knows that they can make a difference. I'm sure you all will agree with me. Leaders always take the responsibility of their action, either it is a good or bad. But it should not happen that leaders say that all goods are mine and bads are of other person. No, you always take this total responsibility. Here I like to remind you that our president, 11th president, APJ Abdul Kalam Sahab, right, I'm sure you all will agree with me. When there was the first missile shoot was there and it was a failure, then his boss, Mr. Colonel Chopra, he said, no problem, this is my responsibility, it is due to me it got failed. The second time when the missile got cleared in the satellite, it got to the space, what he said, now you go and attend the press conference. I will not go. See, this is the way the leadership can be seen, and you can we can identify about the leadership part. And leader don't procrastinate. They will do the things immediately. They will not say that, okay, I will see later. No. And later, and leaders are always very inquisitive, which I'm sure you will agree with me. So these are the very, very important qualities of any good leader which is there. And leaders always own their commitment and mistake, which I told you, give an example of APJ Sahab. I think is one of the missile men of India, of the world. And this is one of the finest examples. Instead of giving my example or somebody else's examples, let us give the example which every world understands, knows, respect. So, and the other point is, leader always inspire the people. They inspire the people to aspire. They inspire the people to aspire because everybody has the aspiration. And once you start inspiring your own team members, believe you me, you will be respected. It's always says that respect is never ever demanded, and it's always commanded. And how one a leader can command with all these traits, which is very, very important. Every action of the leader has a strong meaning and the reasons, because leader knows that what is the second step, third step, fourth step. Leader will build the people to get the things done, and that's what we have seen in many of the leaders, and that's what we are doing it also. The leaders see the long-term vision and strengthen the strategies, because they understand that what is the outcome of the strategy, what is the ROI of the strategy, and how it is going to be a user-friendly study or not. And they design the change. They are a part and parcel of the change. They are the design maker. They are the change maker today, the change agent, which we say, these are the quality of the leaders. And apart from this, when you are a change agent, you always innovate. When you innovate, the things will happen. And they always challenge the status quo, which is very, very important. They will not go with the mundane routine, the usual routine. They will always say, no, this is the another way where you can make the difference. And they always challenge it in a very positive way, not in a negative way. So again, what are the other traits of the leaders which we have learned? A leader believes in absolute integrity. Because if you don't have the integrity, nobody is going to trust on you. That's the biggest thing. A leader always inspires others without any compromise. The leader is going to tell very clearly, this is the pros, this is the cons. Right? In spite of pros and cons, these are the outcome is there. This is the benefit is there. This is the positiveness is there. So that is the beauty of the leader, which makes a difference, which I'm sure you will agree with me. When I talk about the integrity, honesty is a part of it. When I talk about the honesty, then trust is automatically is a part of that part. It's like we are talking about which is more important, brain is important or heart is important or lung is important. Everything is important for a human body. Same thing is honesty, trust, integrity is important for a leader. And leaders are self-motivated and act with humility and humanity. That's what we have seen about the Tata Sahab, that humility and humanity is the foremost requirement of a leader. You have to be very, very humble and ground to the earth. That is the beauty of it. Because when you are a leader, you are on the top position. People, they will see towards you and you can see down. And when you see down, that is the right way of putting the thing with the humility and humanity. And that's why the respect will come. And of course, self-discipline is a basic requirement. Because if I'm sure all of us are self-disciplined, because nobody is going to tell us about the self-discipline. They admire our self-discipline, they respect our self-discipline, they love our self-discipline. That's why we have been admired as a good leader. So skills, what are the skills are there? So now I'm talking about something very, very different part. Because this earlier part which I have spoken about the traits. Now, apart from the traits, now what are the skills? Because we are talking about the development of the skills, which I'm sure we all have, but it is always good that let us rework it out and make the things happen. Leaders communicate well. Why I'm saying so? Because leader will have the communication end-to-end level, end-to-end level. Because it is very important how, what you want to do, how you want to do, when you want to do, where you want to do, and what is the end result of it. This is the complete loop has been cleared by the leader. This is a very important thing, which is, and with the proper communication. When I say communication, it means what they want to communicate. The other person who is listening, he or she should understand it very well. Because there's a, you all will agree with me, there's a difference between a listening and a hearing. So a leader always ensures there should be a listening part, not a hearing part, because the outcome will be there if the listening is proper. Leaders are visionary, I told you. Leaders are innovative, I told you. Decision making is one of the very, very important part, because the entire organization or wherever we all are working, they are dependent on the leaders, because your decision can build heaven of a difference or our decision can destroy the thing. So we have to be visionary, we have to be innovative to ensure that our decision should not be in the negative side. And problem solving, because people will come to get the solution of the problem. People will never come to us to get rid of the thing. So it is very important that we should be a problem solver, because we are the person who understand the things on the top level. We can see in a better way. It is always there when you are in a building of 15th floor. So on the 15th floor, when you are there, right, you can see anything and everything which are happening. The people on the first floor, second floor, third floor, they cannot see so much, but you are having the complete eye view, which is there. And leaders also know how to delegate work and where to delegate work and to which person to delegate work. Because as God has not made the five fingers equal, same way every person is having the capability, every person is having the strength. So leader can analyze that beautiful strength of the person, that which person is strong enough to make the difference. So that's why they delegate it so beautifully that the outcome is 100%. Outcome is the desired one. Outcome is the required one. Now, another part of the leader is which I want to explain, soft skills. Again, what? Humanity, I told you. This is one of the basic thing, because ultimately people work for people and people also live for the people. So it's always said that people work for people and people live due to the bosses. So Hindi mein ek baat bolta hun. Hindi mein they say ki kisi ke aane se muskaan aati hai chehre pe aur kisi ke jaane se chehre pe muskaan aati hai. So now we have to be there, which type of person we have. That when we enter in that group of the people, there should be a smile on the faces. It should not happen when you leave that place or the conference room, everybody will smile that, okay, gone. So that is not a right leadership, right? That is a bossism, that is a Hitlership, which nobody will like to it now. Humanity, and second is care for others, compassion. And I was talking about the EI part. Today, you have to touch the heart of the person. Right, everybody is intelligent, everybody is brilliant, everybody knows the technology. But after all, the emotional intelligence is going to make a heaven of a difference. If you have touched the heart of the person, they will do anything for you. They will go all out for you. And I have seen in this corona time, we as a medical pharma company, not we, many other companies, we were so much in touch with our people, because they were supposed to go out. They were supposed to go and meet the doctor. They were supposed to go and meet the chemist. They were supposed to go to meet the distributor. We were touching them. We were inquiring about their families. We are talking to them once in a week. And that's why they were so much resonated with us. They started having a lot of love, respect. So this is the way that you can make a difference on it. Passion. Without passion, nothing will happen. Without passion, nothing will happen, because the changes are required. Resilience is another very important thing, because if we are not resilient, then again, the things will not move forward. So learn how to make decisions and be ready for change your mind. People will keep on pushing you in a bad way. This is the one of the things, but it is always clear that to make decisions, be ready. What the decisions required, People will have a lot of the hurdles will be there, but you are very, very clear that this hurdle should not be taken. Be very cool, calm in that way. And effective leadership objective, which I like to highlight here, effectiveness and efficiency at the work. I have seen the people, they will, suppose they have to have the work of 8 hours, they will keep on dragging for 12 hours, 13 hours. They destroy their time and destroy their subordinate time. I always preach, and I practice it, that as a leader, you should be effective and efficient at our workplace. Time is not the thing. If you are lingering the time, I means it is very, very clear that we are not effective and efficient. At least for me, I always say. So plan the things in advance. Make the things clear cut. What are the basic things are there? And be efficient to finish it up. Be effective to make the things happen. Finish your work. Let your colleagues should also enjoy. And you should enjoy. There will be happiness. And if you start, one person start dragging from 9 o'clock to 9 o'clock in the evening, you can understand there will be no humbleness will be there. No happiness will be there. So another second point is gain knowledge and keep learning. In the VUCA world, everybody was talking about learning, unlearning, and relearning. Yes, it is true. This VUCA world, this 2020 has given us so much enormous opportunity to learn. So upgradation of the knowledge is must. Now every 3 years, the things are getting changed, which we have seen. And it will be changed in every 3 years. Whatever we have learned, it is not going to happen in 3 years of time. I was talking to Saurabh Ji. I said that in our medical field, artificial intelligence is going to make an $80 billion industry. $80 billion industry. Today, it is just $3.5 billion. You can understand that how AI is going to play a role in 2025. And it is not only in pharmaceutical, in the entire things. AI is going to make a difference. So we have to learn. And at the same time, people, they say that they'll not get the job, but we say job will be enormous. Upgrade yourself and be a tech savvy and the things are going to happen. So you always help in leading and building others. So attributes. Now I'm talking about I spoke about the traits. I spoke about the soft skills. Now I'm going to talk about the attributes of a good leader. So basics of the leadership, which I'm sure you will agree that a leader always build cohesiveness and coherence so that the missions get done. So again, cohesiveness and coherence, how it can happen with the compassion, with the humility, while telling the thing, while communicating the thing, while making it very short and simple so that the people should understand it. Because it is very, very clear that as a leader, our understanding is much ahead as compared to our peer group, as compared to our team members. But we have to go on their level and we have to ensure that we should be communicating to them so that they should understand. Ultimately, our peer group, our team members, they are going to do the job. We are not going to do the job. We are not available everywhere. But whatever the guidance which we are giving, that will be available with them everywhere to make the things happen. That is the beauty of this. And again, I told you that leader always understand that which team, which person is having the strength. What is strength? Everybody is having strength. Everybody. I have not seen in my so many years of the leadership life or the senior management life on this position, that person doesn't have this strength. It depends upon the person, how you take that strength for that particular person. If somebody says that this person has failed, believe you me, I say no, the person has never failed. It is his boss, it is his senior who made him fail. And it is true because his senior or her senior is not able to find the strength of the person, not able to delegate the things, not able to make the things happen for the person. That's the reason the person has failed. Today in the professional world, nobody wants to have the failure track. Nobody, right? So everybody wants to put the best of the best effort. But now it depends upon us as a leader that how we are going to attribute our things in the particular persons so that the person should start performing and he should be or she should be always felicitated or recognized as an achiever. So that's why the leader always create a group. Suppose you are in a senior position, you have multiple people working under you. So you understand that let us make a group of these things. They are strong in communication, they are strong in delivering, they are strong in procuring. So this group is going to make a lot of difference and everybody will work towards 100% of giving their things. So that is the beauty of the leadership. That's the attributes of the leader. Supporting skills, I already told you, communication is one of the finest tool, because people will not remember whatever the favor you have done. People will remember how well you have communicated. This is the way. If you have communicated well, people will go all out and they will make a difference. So it is very, very important. Second part, you will agree with me that if there is a requirement of the organization, the presentation which you are giving it should be on dot on the requirement, dot on the, they're not beating around the bush. And at the same time, a leader always manages the time. Don't linger it, because nobody wants to linger it, right? So be a very clear-cut time manager yourself, change agent, time manager, and this is a supporting skill which is required. People will not say in front of us that this person is a poor time management person. People will say that he's not able to manage himself. And that is the reason Mr. Saurav was telling about my video on time management. I say, no, there's no time management. In the entire world, everybody is having the 7 days in a week. Everybody is having 24 hours in a day. But it depends. Somebody drag it to 28 hours, means they keep on putting the thing, and somebody finish in 20 hours of time. So it is the self-management which makes a difference. Time will be the same. So start managing yourself better. And once we start managing ourselves, or once we start managing ourselves, believe you me, the team is, they will start following it up. And I've seen, and that is the reason I say, even in my profession, even in my vertical, all the people, all, even either the corona or the non-corona, everybody is an achiever, which I have seen it and I have noticed it, and I inculcated the things along with that team. Not only me, but everybody has inculcated the same thing. And that is the reason I say that time management and everything has played a vital role apart from other things. Advanced leadership skills. Again, because it is not the end of the story. We have to see what is going to happen after 2 years, what is going to happen in the 3 years of time. So fire your imagination to win in the future. Let us learn what is going to happen there, what is happening in the abroad, what is happening in the next organization, what is happening in other areas. So if they are doing so much, then why we can't do? We have, God has given us same 206 bones. God has given us same brain. God has given us same strength. Then we should be doing it and ensuring the things. And again, be ethical, know your job, which is very important, and do what is right. Don't favor it up. Never be a biased person. If you are a biased, people will not respect you, they will not obey you. So absolutely, a leader has to be very, very ethical if you have to grow, and you have to make your team grow also on the same level. So now I am talking about the new thing, the HPL. HPL, what is the high performance leadership, which is required now? Because whenever I attend the multiple meetings and seminars of the leaders across the world, they talk about HPL. And what is the HPL is? HPL is, it is a clear-cut jumping shift. What the trend is going on, we cannot be going as per the trend. What is more is available, we have to jump for that. We have to see, we have to analyze, and then only we can make the thing different. Because when we are working in any of the professional organization, right, they always want to have a better jump. And with the high performance leadership, we can make the things happen. And what are the ingredients are there? Ingredients, clear cut, clear vision, no myopic vision, no mundane way, right? Stretching the goals, powerful strategies, again, along with the team, alone, fine, you can make it, but your team can further add the things. Why I'm saying is powerful strategy. Suppose you have to have, 30% growth in any of the organization, and your current growth is going on 15%, and you have a team of 5 or 10 people are there. So call a meeting. If you call a meeting and you are going to have a plan for the next year, you tell all your colleagues that fine, please come with one idea, right? How to have a 30% growth, because our organization requirement is that we should grow by 30%. Tell everybody. And believe you me, when the 10 people will come and meet you, you will have 10 ideas plus one of your idea, 11 ideas. When all people will go out from that particular conference room, everybody will carry 11 ideas with them. That is the beauty of powerful strategy, stretching the goals. That is the way we work on this. We always throw the ideas to the people. We said, this is the way we are going to do it. Please come back after 2 days of time. Think more. Think out of the box thinking. What more can be done? Maybe we have to scrap some of the ideas. Fine, not a problem. But people will always open their mind. It's like the umbrella or the parachute. Till the time it will not open, you will not be saved. Same thing is, idea is going to come. It's the brain which is going to put the thing. And then you put the operating imperatives, which is very important. So that is the way high performance leadership works. And it is not only in India, in entire segment, in the entire globe, it is working and people are marching ahead to make the things happen. Because even in our pharmaceutical company, we have seen a wonderful growth by many of the companies, and we have also seen a mundane growth or a carry-on growth which is there. So people, they don't take for their part. But this is the way that we make the changes in that. Yeah. So what are the other important things are there? That for this high performance leadership, it provides a clear vision. Because if you are in 2021, we have to see in 2025 what we are doing. Believe you me, as a leader, we have to have a 5 years plan. We say na, that we make a roadmap. So it is important to make our roadmap on 5 years and visit that roadmap on every 6 months, if not that every year, that yes, what is the positive and what is what we have missed. But if we are doing this thing on every 6 months of time, we can manage our remaining 6 months for the coming time. So we can change that thing, that where we are missing the things and what are the new things can be incorporated with this. And that is the reason we say that 5 years plan is very important for any leader or for any organization. Even we work for 5 years plan. We know that where we have to reach. So when our goal is clear, then we can understand. Suppose from, I'm based at Ahmedabad. I have to reach to Bombay and I have only 8 hours of time. So I'll see that, right? I have to reach and attend the meeting. What is the best possible options available? I will start exploring the options. But if I say, okay, day after tomorrow I have to reach, then I have multiple options are there. So I will become very lazy in choosing the things. But if we have the less time, we started working on this. And that is the way that we work. So provides a clear vision. Think outside the box, I already told you. Creates an aligned team. I have given you example of the aligned team. Then 10 people coming to you, they are equally aligned. They think alike. They come with the ideas. Again, the leader builds a strong, empowered organization, which is very important because when you are working, organization depends on the leader. Organization is not, cannot make the things happen. It is a people. It is we. We are organization. We are the company. 5 people who are working, we are the company. We are the company. Organization is nothing there. It's only one person who is driving it, but we are the actual drivers. The entire steering is in our hand. Set and maintain the high standard. We are supposed to have the high standard because if we are having the high standard, I am now talking about something different. Because our new generation, the new generation which is going to lead, they will have a high standard thinking. Because again, I'm saying that I was talking to Mr. Saurabhji. He said that the requirement of Charles Darwin's theory, survival of the fittest. And for survival of the fittest, it is very important that we should develop not ourselves, but we should develop our future leaders, the young generations, to see 1 step ahead, 2 steps ahead, 3 steps ahead. Because they have the capacity, because they are tech savvy, they understand the things. They can be very helpful. I never degrade my juniors, I'm telling you. The junior person is most respected person because I always ask, what is the new thing which you have learned? Probably I have not learned on this age and this stage, but the person who has just come from, I've done the MBA or 1 year, 2 years of the experience, they have come with the latest things. Not many things are coming up. So that's why we keep on learning from them. They say, let us come out of the box thinking. And believe you me, their suggestions are always respected. We discuss, we make the things happen, we take the things happen, and then we do it. So that is the beauty that we are there. And that's the reason we always demonstrate the integrity. We love them, we respect them, we felicitate the people that yes, this guy has added strength in the organization. This guy, and then we give the responsibility to the person. Try to understand, a 30 years young person getting the responsibility to run the show, my God, he feels so excited. Every day or every week will come something brand new. And believe you me, that will be really being taken by any person, every person. So this is the way we inspire the people. So what high performance result? Dramatic change is going to happen. We have seen in pharmaceutical industry, our organization has grown. where the industry was growing by 3%, 4%, we have grown by more than 10%. Three times, four times we have grown. Kerala is known to be grown in every month on month, three times more, four times more as compared to industry, because we were seeing our group of people, not only me, my senior, my president, my colleagues, my junior people, my peer group, everybody was thinking alike. So this was the thing the high performance result has come. Develop and empower employees. We have given a lot of leniency. Yes, please go ahead. If you are failure, it is my problem. If you are successful, it is the organization going to be successful through you. And that is the way we have motivated our people to have the performance. Here on this platform, I must tell, in my vertical, 25 months are over. Month on month, our entire division vertical have performed more than 100%. Because we have empowered our people. We said, go ahead. What will happen? It will be a failure, not an issue. We will take the failure. But if successful, you are successful, organization is successful. And that was the high performance result has come. And sustain the momentum. So good things to be always sustained. You should not start scrapping. 1 year, this is over. Second, you take something new. Third year, something new. No, don't do it. At least have the momentum for 3 years of time, because you are getting results. And it is always said that always build your strength. Don't jump here and there. If you have the strength, you will be able to build it very fast. If you don't have the strength, don't go jump here. Today, suppose we as a Cadillac, I'm just giving my pharma industry an example. We are very strong in gastro segment. We are strong in cardio segment. We are strong in the physician segment. But if we want to go in a pediatric segment, which is not our strength, we will not be successful as the way we are successful. So same way in the different profession, when you are strong in that particular segment, either it is a niche segment or the total segment, start building it up. And you will find that the strengthen, you are going to strengthen the things in the entire